The I-94 Commons, the location where we set up the I-94 field laboratory, is a convenient location very close to the university campus that has the unfortunate happenstance of being the highest crash location in the state of Minnesota. It's not a dangerous location because the crashes are happening at low speeds, but there is a lot of them as compared to any other location, meaning one every 2 days. So we have three locations, three rooftops that are overlooking the stretch of I-94, and we have placed our equipment and our cameras there to have a continuous coverage of data and video from vehicles as soon as they enter the area and until they leave it.
Autoscope was conceived in my mind in 1985 from the need to be able to detect traffic over a wide area of the road for better traffic management and also for wireless detection. MnDOT grasped the idea and funded initial research on the subject, and later on we got additional funding through CTS and from the Federal Highway Administration until we finally commercialized it in 1991.
MnDOT and other organizations with the detectors that they have on the system, they're collecting aggregated information. So volume, average speed, average occupancy, average density. We are interested on a very microscopic scale of what are the movements and what are the behavior of individual vehicles. So the Autoscope was the only sensor that would allow us to do that.
The Traffic Observatory does a lot of research projects for us. They can help test new equipment, new practices in intelligent transportation systems. Those are systems where we're using technology to help try to improve congestion and also improve safety. They've done a couple of different projects for us, one testing a cue warning system that can help notify motorists that there's stop traffic ahead and help improve safety. Our role and responsibility is really to manage traffic on a daily basis, and so it's nice to be able to partner with the University of Minnesota as they have the staff and the resources to be able to maybe spend a little bit more time researching new techniques, new technologies, and testing those, and then also helping to do some analysis of some of the systems that we have deployed. And so that additional resources really helps benefit MnDOT in being able to kind of quantify what we do, but then also kind of taking it the next step forward.